when the central bank governor appeared before the finance committees of both the Senate and the National Assembly, he pointed out that the bank would be keeping a close eye on the developments on the shilling and would act and rein in on the volatility in the market. As such, many analysts thought that he would hike the central bank rate for the third time in 3 months to ward off further weakening of the local unit. But instead, the governor pulled a fast one on the entire market. Adelaide Chingole tells us about the rate hike that never was.
Over the last 1 month, focus has been on the new central bank governor and his efforts to rein in the wayward shilling. Despite being in office for just 6 weeks, the new governor had defied expectations and implemented a 300 basis point increase in the central bank rate to try and support the weakening shilling. As he chaired an unprecedented third Monetary Policy Committee meeting in just 3 months, and in the backdrop of the continued depreciation of the shilling, everyone expected him to effect yet another rate hike.
We've penciled in a forecast for a hike of at least 100 basis points.
According to the analysts, the central bank needed to increase the rate to give further support to the shilling. In the analysis, the shilling would come under even more pressure once the U.S. raises the Federal Reserve rate later in the year. This would result in the further global strengthening of the dollar.
But you know, our argument is that you need to stop the bleeding now, you need to slow down the bleeding now before you get your fiscal house in order.
Moreover, the country's inflation rate was likely to rise following the 3 shilling increase in the fuel levy that will become effective this month. But in what is fast becoming the modus operandi for the new central bank governor, Dr. Jaroge pulled a fast one on the entire market. While everyone was waiting for a rate hike, the governor instead opted to retain the rate and changed at 11.5%. In a statement, the governor cited the falling inflation rate, which had dropped to 4-month lows, the stable exchange rate, increased foreign direct investment, and recovery of the tourism and agricultural sectors are some of the reasons for the decision to retain the central bank rate at 11.5%.
So the flow in tourism and the increased price of tea back to $3 may bring in inflows that may counter the challenge that we have with exchange rate.
Moreover, Dr. Njoroge said the measures taken in the previous meetings, particularly the increase in the Kenya Bank's referencing rate, KBRR, were yet to be fully transmitted to the economy. Banks are expected to price the increase into their lending rates this month.
We've been watching to see whether indications will be so that we see how the burden of increased interest rates will be shared.
All right. So far, have you adjusted your lending rates up?
We're waiting for the central bank meeting tomorrow to lead their lips and then respond.
So far, the central bank has been supplementing its rate hike with frequent interventions in the market to stem volatility. This has resulted in tight liquidity conditions that has seen the interbank rate, the rate at which banks lend to each other, rise from 8.50% to historic highs of 21.26%.
We personally think that if the central bank continues its hawkish stance, you know, there's going to be leaner times ahead for the shilling. And in terms of the interbank rate, you know, where it is at 20, slightly north of 19%, but it's not a solution to actually convince portfolio investors to come back to the market. I think, you know, another firm signal from the Central Bank of Kenya later today is definitely needed.
So was the decision to retain the rate at 11.5% wise? Analysts say it could come at a heavy cost to the economy by worsening the foreign sell-offs that have characterized the equity market this year and further hurting the shilling.
Last couple of weeks, there has been a consensus shift because of the fact that the governor has spoken about the debt levels and the fiscal side of things helping out monetary policy. Mm-hmm. And, you know, failure to act today will perhaps really be misinterpreted by the market that the Central Bank of Kenya has done all it can for the shilling, and now it's put its hands up and fallen back and said the dollar is the king. So I think, you know, it will be taken slightly negative by the market for the shilling. I think the shilling will perhaps continue to weaken on the back of that.
Adelaide Chingole, KTN Business.